what was your first gig or just like career moment where you thought like, whoa, this is a step up now, like I've kind of I'm in the next league, if you like. I know that's maybe not the best way to look at it, but I feel like that mentally it does happen.
That's a tough question. I think when I was a lot younger and I started, you know, this wasn't necessarily like, oh, look at me, I'm playing massive gigs or anything. But it was when I started getting regularly called by successful session musicians in London. Because I guess you could say I'm kind of, even though I don't think the term session musician really applies anymore, I don't think there's such a thing. But when I started getting called regularly by musicians and the phone was ringing going, oh, hey, can you do this? Or do you want to do this? Or do you want to do that? You know, they weren't necessarily big gigs in big venues, but it was the fact that I was getting called by my peers and people that I respected. I think that was, for me, a big part where I was suddenly like, this is going okay. You know, the size, for me at the time, it wasn't about the size of the gig or the size of the artist. It was about the caliber of musician I was playing with. And the fact that these people that I looked up to were actually giving me the time of day and calling me, I think that was quite a defining moment where I thought, this is cool. I think I'm doing something right.
Yeah, it's interesting that you kind of pick something that relates actually more to, it ties in with how comedians love impressing other comedians. You know, I think any good comedian would rather make a comedian laugh than the audience, almost, because it's an indication of like you're doing something right. Because I guess, you know, there's lots of cheap jokes out there that you could make that might make an audience laugh, but maybe don't have much substance. I guess the same goes for music, you know. But yeah, it's also interesting that you didn't pick a particular gig or anything, that actually it relates more to a sense of like, I don't quite know, a kind of
it's a sense of feathering myself, a sense that I'm on the right path, and what I'm doing to get to where I want to go is working. I think.
Yeah.
I think it's definitely that. So yeah, it's interesting actually. It wasn't about, oh, I'm playing Wembley, therefore, you know, I've made it. It was more about just the continuing process of where I was trying to get to. I think very few people, you know, are here and then a week later they're up here. You know, it doesn't work like that for the majority of us. It's more of a casual burn up. So I think it was just knowing that things were going in the right direction. I think that was almost a defining moment for me.